Hi, I'm Aini from Global Barcoding Technologies and I'm Bahad. If you are interested in knowing more about our company, you can visit our official website and our Facebook page. For further inquiries, you can directly email our marketing manager, Ms. Stephanie. In this video, I want to share the SQL accounting tutorial. For today's lesson, I'm going to show you the purchase modules for purchase order transaction. Normally, this is the first transaction in the purchase module. Somehow in Malaysia, many people may not use purchase order. They will directly call the supplier and make the purchase. But I suggest to use this transaction to keep it on track. Okay, now let's start. Click on the purchase order. First thing that you will see is the listing of the previous purchase order transaction. As you can see here, the empty row below the column header is actually the searching area. If you want to search the previous transaction based on the previous order number, you can click in here and key in the purchase order number. But if you don't remember, you can search based on other criteria, for example like company. Just key in the company name and then all the details regarding the previous purchase order will come out. Let's say if you want to search based on other criteria, you can right click on the column header and go to the field chooser and drag out any data or information that you want to be shown on the column header. For example, like area, just drag and put on the column header right here. And then it will show all the area for the certain company, for the particular company. And also, you can export all the data to the Microsoft Excel. Just right click on the column header here and go to the grid export, and you can choose either you want to export to the Excel, HTML, text or XML, but normally user will export to the Microsoft Excel. Okay, so let's start by create a new purchase order. Click on new button here. And the first thing that you have to key in is the supplier name. As you can see here, the company name is in bold because I'm using the company name as the focus key for the searching criteria. If you want to search based on other criteria, for example like code, you just tap on the tab button on your keyboard and then it will shift to another column. But for me, it will be much more easier to search based on company name because I can't really remember all the code for the company. So, let's key in here. Okay, so you can see here, the purchase order number is empty. It's okay because the system have the auto running number. So, later on, it will be automatically updated by the system. Okay, key in the item, just click on the plus sign here and enter the item code. As you can see here, I'm using description as the focus key for the searching area. And if you want to search based on other criteria, you can just tap on tab button on your keyboard and then it will shift to another column. You can always edit the quantity over here, the price, and if you want to give some discount, you can enter the discount over here. And don't worry, the system will automatically calculate the subtotal for you. And if you want to add on another item, just click on plus button here and do the exactly same way. If you want to upload another criteria or another data to the table, you can right click on the column header and go to the field chooser. For example, like if you want to put on more description, you can drag and put it here. For more description, you can enter, for example, like the expired year is 2018. Yeah, rather than click on save button here, it will be much more easier if you click on the close button here and followed by yes. You can actually move the item up and down accordingly by clicking the arrow button here. And once you're done by keying in all the items, click on save button here. As you can see, the purchase order number is automatically updated by the system. And before you print out, I always advise the user to preview first. Click on preview button here and choose your preferable template. So basically, this is the purchase order report that you just created. And if you want to print, just click on print button here. If you want to export, you can export either to PDF or Excel, but normally user will export it to PDF, then straight away can email to the supplier. So this is how you create your purchase order. That's all for me today. I'm Aini from Global Barcoding Technologies.